Hi there. I'm sure you've heard of these words: dozen, hat-trick, quartet, and pair. You will agree with me, they are all meaningful numbers. For example, a dozen is a group of 12 of the same thing. A hat-trick are just three successes achieved by one person. A quartet are a group of four musicians or singers who play or sing together, while a pair is just two things of the same type. Now, what is the importance of these words in this lesson? Well, similarly, the mole is a name for a meaningful number in chemistry. So just like we have the word dozen representing the number 12, the mole also represents something. This is Ed Online School, and in this video, you and I will be looking at an introduction to the mole concept. We are going to do this in a systematic way, and by the end of this video, you will be able to know the key definitions of a mole, the formulas from the definitions, how to use the first formula we'll talk about, and at the end of this video, we've got some bonus tips for you. So make sure you watch this video till the end to get the maximum value out of it. Let's begin with looking at the key definitions of a mole. The first is one which I like to refer to as the basic definition of a mole, because this is the definition of a mole that defines it as a name of a meaningful number, meaning this definition actually tells us the number to which a mole is equal to. A mole is an amount of substance that is equivalent to 6.02 times 10 to the power 23. And for this definition, you should be able to recall that this number, which is 6.02 times 10 to the power 23, is referred to as the Avogadro's constant or the Avogadro's number. By understanding this definition, you should appreciate that if we were to get any number of particles, as long as they are equal to 6.02 times 10 to the power 23, that number of particles can be referred to as one mole. For example, if we have 6.02 times 10 to the power 23 oxygen atoms, we can say that we have one mole of oxygen atoms. Again, if we were to get 6.02 times 10 to the power 23 of water molecules, we can say we have one mole of water molecules. And if we were to stretch this a little, 6.02 times 10 to the power 23 books is equal to one mole of books. However, this third example is just quite imaginary. You might never be asked such a question because it's non-chemistry based. And a mole is an amount of mass equal to the relative atomic mass or relative molecular mass. So if you get the mass of a certain substance and that mass is equal to the relative atomic mass of that substance or the relative molecular mass of that substance, then you have gotten one mole of that substance. Now, you should understand that the relative atomic mass is the mass of an atom compared to carbon 12 isotope. Therefore, if you're finding the number of moles of an atom, likely you use the relative atomic mass to see if that amount of mass you've gotten is one mole. In other videos, we'll talk about more of this definition and how it's used in chemistry. The relative molecular mass, on the other hand, is the mass of a molecule compared to carbon 12 isotope. And as you can see, just the names can give you an idea of which is which. You can see in RAM there's atomic, so it's the mass of an atom, while in RMM, which is relative molecular mass, there's molecule, so this is mass of a molecule. Let's look at some examples of this. Here is a part of a periodic table that is very helpful to understand this definition. We've got elements from hydrogen to argon. You bear with me, the names are not on this periodic table, we just have symbols. But let's focus on oxygen for a start. Oxygen is number 8. If we check the number on the top part of oxygen, which is the superscript, we have the number 16. This number 16 is what we are referring to as the relative atomic mass. So if we get an amount of mass of oxygen which is 16 grams, then we've gotten a mole of oxygen. The next example is, let's say we got the element carbon here, which is number 6. You can see its relative atomic mass is 12. Therefore, if we get 12 grams of carbon, we have gotten one mole of carbon. Here we've got sulfur and oxygen bonding together to form sulfur dioxide, meaning we have two oxygens and one sulfur. And if we check, sulfur is number 16, has the atomic mass 32, oxygen is number 8 and has the atomic mass 16. Now, since we have two oxygens, we have two 16s. Therefore, 16 plus 16 will be 32. The other sulfur we had there was also 32. And if we find the sum of 32 and 32, we are going to have 64. Therefore, if we get 64 grams of sulfur dioxide, we have collected one mole of sulfur dioxide. The third definition is also very interesting and important. In this third definition, we are talking about a mole only related to gases. So if we get a volume of gas equivalent to 24 cubic decimeters or 22.4 cubic decimeters, we have collected a mole of that gas. Now, you should note that 24 cubic decimeters is the volume of gases at room temperature and pressure, while 22.4 cubic decimeters is the volume of gases at standard temperature and pressure. Later in this video, you know the values for room temperature and pressure and standard temperature and pressure. Now, let's see how this definition can be applied. If we get 24 cubic decimeters of nitrogen gas at room temperature and pressure, we can confidently say we have one mole of nitrogen. Again, if we get 24 cubic decimeters of carbon dioxide at room temperature and pressure, we can say we've collected one mole of carbon dioxide. If we get 22.4 cubic decimeters of oxygen gas at standard temperature and pressure, we have one mole of oxygen. You should be able to relate the 24 cubic decimeters with room temperature and pressure, the 22.4 cubic decimeters with standard temperature and pressure. You should never switch these two volumes. You should not mistake this for having the same mass. These two gases might have the same number of moles, but because they have got different atomic masses, they will necessarily not have the same masses. If you get one mole of carbon dioxide, it will likely be heavier than one mole of nitrogen, even though they are occupying the same space. Now, let's look at some formulas from these definitions, which is also one thing that is very important when we're talking about mole concept. From the first definition, we're going to get the formula, from the second, and from the third. In the first formula, you can remember we talked about number of particles. We said a mole is an amount of substance that is equivalent to 6.02 times 10 to the power 23. And now, N, which is the mole, is equal to number of particles divided by Avogadro's constant. Because we know if we get 6.02 times 10 to the power 23 of any compound, we have one mole. So if we get that number and put it on top, divide by the Avogadro's constant, we have one. Therefore, this formula is the formula that comes from our first definition. It's easier to remember like this. N is equal to N of P divided by 6.02 times 10 to the power 23. You should take note that N is for the number of moles, and the particles can be atoms, ions, molecules, or electrons. Therefore, you might be told to calculate the number of moles of a particular atoms, the number of moles of ions, the number of moles of molecules or electrons. The second formula comes from the second definition. We said a mole is an amount of mass that is equivalent to the relative atomic mass or the relative molecular mass. Therefore, one mole is equal to the physical mass of a substance divided by its relative atomic mass or its relative molecular mass. And now, if these two masses are equal, we'll be dividing by the same thing, and therefore our answer will be 1. N is equal to M over MR is the more natural way of referring to this formula. And again, you should note that N is for the number of moles, MR is for molar mass. And when you talk about molar mass, it's just the mass of that particular molecule or atom that is equal to one mole. You should note that if the number of moles being calculated are for an atom, The molar mass is just the same as the relative atomic mass. Now let's talk about the final formula, which is formula 3. This formula comes from the third definition, where we said a volume of a gas that is equivalent to 24 cubic decimeters at RTP is 1 mole, and a volume of gas which is equivalent to 22.4 cubic decimeters is also 1 mole. Therefore, N is equal to the physical volume of a particular gas divided by the molar volume. And now we know molar volumes change depending on the conditions where that experiment is being done. In abbreviation, this formula is N is equal to V over MV. You should note that N is the number of moles, and you should also note that MV is different depending on the conditions. At RTP, the molar volume is 24 cubic decimeters. At STP, the molar volume is 22.4 cubic decimeters. These three formulas are the basis of the mole concept. There's one other formula that's also very important, but it's not really a formula that's needed right from the start. Later, when we do much in mole concept, it will be introduced. Now, let's talk about how we can use the first formula. The first formula is the easiest to use of all these three formulas we've looked at in this lesson. And for that reason, it's been added to this video. The other two will be looked at in a later video. In the first question, we've been asked to calculate the number of moles in 2.4 times 10 to the power 23 molecules of sulfur dioxide, which is shown there as SO2. Since we're using our first formula, we don't need to worry about much. We're just going to substitute the number of particles with the number of molecules we've been given, because we know molecules are particles. N will be equal to 2.4 times 10 to the power 23 divided by our Avogadro's constant. We're going to use a calculator for this calculation, and you're going to see how it can be done. And as you can see, our answer is shown on screen as 0.39871093. It would be best that you do these calculations as the video is going on, because as you do it, it will be stored in your memory easier. We're going to write this number correct to three significant figures. And so, as you can see, we are going to round off this 6 and we'll have 0.399. In B, we're asked to calculate the number of molecules in 2 moles of glucose. So here it's just a matter of making the number of particles the subject of the formula. Or you can just plug in the number of moles where there's N, then work it out just like it's some algebra. But let's see the number of particles written as the subject. So the number of particles will be equal to the number of moles multiplied by the Avogadro's constant. As you can see here, it's been abbreviated because of the space. But now let's get solving. So number of particles is equal to 2 times 6.02 times 10 to the power 23. This can be found easily by just multiplying this 2 by the 6.02. Now what you see is you have 12.04. Now because we have 12.04, we need to change it into the correct standard form. Now, instead of going through all that procedure and beginning to explain some math, let's just use the calculator. As you can see, our answer is given and it's correct. 1.204 times 10 to the power 24. If we take 12.04 into scientific notation, it will be 1.204 times 10 to the power 1, or just simply times 10. Therefore, when we use our indices learnt in math, we can easily come to this same answer without a calculator. Because our numbers are not so much, I think we can write the number of particles just like they were on the calculator. This is how we can use the first formula. For the other two formulas we've looked at in this video, watch out for our next video in chemistry so that you know how to use them. You have finally reached the bonus tip section. In today's video, we've got three tips for you. The first is about the person who found the Avogadro's constant. He was an Italian mathematical physicist, and his name was Lorenzo Amedeo Carlo Avogadro. And as you can see, this number was named after him. He was not actually the one who named it. This story about Avogadro is quite interesting. What happened was that at the time Avogadro was still alive, many of the scientists never regarded his thinking about the number of particles of one mole being equal to 6.0 times 10 to the power 23. But after some time when he died, they came to realize his thinking was actually true. And so scientists said, let's honor this guy and name this number after him. The second tip is about what the values for standard temperature and pressure, room temperature and pressure are. Standard temperature is the temperature equal to 0 degrees Celsius, while standard pressure is pressure equal to 1 atmosphere. Room temperature is equal to 25 degrees Celsius, and room pressure is just the same as standard pressure. And now that temperature change is very important for gases, because gases are easily affected by temperatures. The third tip is about the Avogadro's law. The Avogadro's law was touched. Maybe you just never knew we were using it. When we talked about the third definition of the mole, you can remember we used something related to this. Avogadro's law states that one mole of every gas occupies the same volume at the same temperature and pressure. Thanks for watching till the end of this video. Watch out for our next video where we'll be talking about how to use the other formulas in more concept.